Hey guys, it's Pastor Craig, and I just wanted to jump on with you for just a few minutes. And of course, the situation, things are fluid. We're seeing a lot of changes happening fast with the coronavirus and what our governments are asking us to do. So we're trying to be a part of the solution, as I talked about Sunday, and flattening that curve. And so we are going to suspend our refuel and upward small groups for the next few weeks. And if you already have your group in an online setting, you're good to go. We'll be offering training so that we can get other small groups up and running. And also we'll be offering resources. So anyone who's maybe not familiar with the video call, we can help them navigate that. It really isn't that complicated once you know what to do. So look for that to happen. We're not in any way trying to dictate what people do as individuals. If you want to have a family come to your house, that's your house. If you want to have prayer on your own. But for things that are on our website, or in our buildings, we're saying as a church, we're trying to do our part with our community leaders to reduce the spread and flatten the curve of the contagious aspect of the coronavirus. And also, please consider, we are trying to protect our most vulnerable. That's what's very important to us. We want to make sure we keep everybody safe. This weekend, I'm going to share some really exciting news about what we're doing with small groups and how we plan to ensure that no one is isolated during this time. It's going to become even more important that we give people opportunity to interact, and we have to do that through on right now. This is also an opportunity for us as a church to exponentially move forward our online efforts. We recognize this is a season. It will come and it will go. We don't know how long that is, but during this season, we're going to capitalize on the opportunity we have right now to really get our people familiar with Zoom calls, video calls, online church, online campuses. It's going to be a great chance for us to move our online church exponentially forward because it's being put upon us, not by choice. Another thing I want you to consider is this. God is positioned our church to lead other churches now. And we want to exemplify what this looks like for them. So it's not just about us, it's about others that may be in a smaller church that don't have the technology, haven't been working on online. We get an opportunity now to really help the body of Christ from being isolated. And also an opportunity to reach out into the community and invite people into that online setting and get out ourselves and become the hands and feet of Jesus. We can't do that in large assemblies now, but you can check on your neighbor. If you have an elderly neighbor or friend, somebody that's vulnerable, doesn't really need to get out and go to the grocery store, you could offer to run to the grocery store for that one that's more vulnerable. I want to assure you this. What we're doing is not perfect, but we are not responding in fear. I personally can tell you that, like you, I'm praying I don't get the virus or anyone that loves me. However, if I did get the virus, I know my life is in God's hands. I would pray for a healing, but my life is in the Lord's hand. Your life is really in the Lord's hand. He's appointed a day on which we will die. It's on His books. So it's not fear when you're a believer. We're not responding in fear. We're responding in wisdom with a sound mind, doing what our government officials are asking us to do and doing even more We're not just doing what they're asking us to do. We're saying, how can we help you? Because we should do more than what's asked of us. We should be the servant. That's the role of a believer. Also, I want to say that I would love to ask you that if you've given by check in the past, try our online or our text giving. It's on our website. It's simple. It's secure. It's actually more secure than a check, because on a check, there's your routing number and your account number and all your information. So a lot of our older generation feels like online giving may not be secure. It's actually more secure than your check. So I want to encourage you to take this opportunity to go on the website and go ahead and enter in your information, get set up to do your online giving. Guys, let me tell you this. This is a tremendous opportunity for revival to come into the world. The whole world is being touched by this. The whole world is being forced to reckon and count their days, consider their days. That's, the Bible says, when we gain a heart of wisdom. When we count our days, we gain a heart of wisdom. So let's point them in the right direction. Let's stay healthy ourselves as best we can so that we can be there to help others. That's what we're going to do at Upward Church. You don't want to miss this weekend. Powerful announcements coming. I think you're going to be so excited for how the Lord prepared us for this moment. I'll go even deeper into how God was preparing us even at the beginning of this year for this moment now. Hey, keep your eyes on Jesus. No fear. God is in control and we're in His hands.